fine, and you?
I'm okay. You're looking good. I like your top.
Okay, thank you.
You can see the ravens through your t-shirt.
Ah,
Nice one.
yeah, thank
Okay,
you.
so we're going to start our. We've only got two episodes to go, so we'll be at the end of the series by the summertime, the summer holidays, and we're doing the Witch's Oracle deck by Marla Brooks. You can get it from Red Feather Publisher. That is a sister company from Sheffer Book Publishers or Publishers, and you'll find the address below. So I hope that has been following the series will be motivated to or interested enough to go and get one themselves or have a look or do more research. And I hope you've enjoyed our collaboration with the Dutch witch Wendy and me, Char from Charlie's Angel Tarot. And if you would love to join our channels, then you can click and see the links below in the description box. And you'll find my email and my YouTube channel for those that have just found me through a Google search or a Wendy's YouTube channel or website as well. We are going to start off with the spider, and we've got a few things that we're going to do extra today. We're going to talk about meditation and incense, and Wendy will be doing her meditation this week, and next week I will be doing my meditation. And here we go. Okay, we've got, sorry, I've got using a different camera now. So I've got the spider, and this is what the spider looks like. Spider. The spider is an ancient symbol of power, mystery, and growth. Much of what the spider has to do, tell us is in construction with its web. The spider weaves an intricate web that serves as its home, the way it gets food to feed itself, and a place of growth for its eggs. For the industrious spider, it is all about survival. The meaning of the card, when the spider appears to tell us in a reading, it is a message of reminding us to be mindful of the choices we are making. If you have been recently pondering a decision and are unsure of what direction to head in, the spider tells you that whatever course you take, it is about weaving your own reality, creating your own web as you desire it to be. Spiders are resilient creatures. If their web gets blown away or knocked down, they simply build another and carry on. And you should do the same. The crystal gemstone is chrysolite. Chrysolite is crystallized by an X-shaped pattern that evokes the image of a spider's web. It is the stone of connection, and it helps you weave together everything you need for health, success, happiness. Use it to reinforce healthy decision-making skills to help everything fall into place. Incantation: the spider weaves a web with care. If it breaks, he will repair. I'll weave my web as I see fit to suit my purpose. Lickety lick, split, sorry, lickety split. I thought lickety lick would be sounds nicer. Lickety split. Okay, that was spider.
Spider. Dus de betekenis, zeg maar, van deze kaart, als je deze kaart hebt, moet je eigenlijk teruggaan in de gedachten over de keuzes die je hebt gemaakt in het leven.
Wendy says, when you get this card, then you have to go back and look what your life has been like, or your life lessons and what you've done. En wat over jezelf over nadenken.
Van in gedachten, van teruggaan naar je gedachten, van de keuzes die je in het verleden hebt gemaakt.
Go back in thought to the choices that you've made.
Ja, hè, van, nou, maar ook de keuzes die je nog gaat maken in de komende periode. En, maar weet wel dat je verantwoordelijk bent voor al je keuzes die je hebt gemaakt en gaat maken.
Also, when you're in thought or think about it, the choices that you will be making in the future, but you have to take responsibility for your choices.
Ja, en ook van, lukt het even niet, begin dan gewoon opnieuw en doe het vol overgave.
If you don't succeed at first, then try again. And do it with definitely with the intention that you're going to succeed.
Ja, en als je dat doet, dan zal het ook goed gaan, want dan dwing je het als het ware af.
If you do that, then you are forcing the energy to make it happen. It's like manifestation, I suppose.
Ja, ja klopt.
Dat It's is, like intention, I'm going to succeed, I will succeed, and it will, you will succeed. Ja. But I think this card also, to me, represents networking.
Ja, communication, networking.
If you've got a business reading, how is my business going to be, and you get this card, then I think of making your own network, your web, your own web. I think of networking.
Ja.
Okay. Thank you, Wendy. And now we're going on to the toad.
Ja.
Ooh, and the slimy creatures. Okay. Ja. For thousands of years, frogs and toads have been associated with myths, folklore, and magic. Many of these myths portray them as demons, creatures associated with the devil. Some cultures, however, view them in a positive light and saw them as representatives of good fortune, protection, rain, fertility, and changing bad luck into good. The toad sometimes symbolizes resurrection and a higher state of spiritual awakening. Toads figure as the guardians of treasures. It is a transformation from tadpole to maturity that renders the toad a frequent symbol of resurrection and rebirth. When this card appears in the reading, you may be experiencing change in your life. The change might be in regard to how you lead your life, but can also be of spiritual nature. Call on the toad to guide you through these times of transitioning. Transition and help you smoothly move from one start to the next. The toad will support your transformation and all metamorphosis in a subtle yet powerful way. The gemstone is serpentine. Serpentine is formed in metamorphic rocks and it supports renewal, regeneration and transformation. Use this stone to help you cope with change gracefully. The incantation. Some things come and some things go. Change is just like ebb and flow. I now accept what has come to be because it is best for me.
A beautiful card.
I love the emerald color green.
Yeah. The glossy over it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Deze kaart duidt aan dat, dat je eigenlijk verwacht dat er veranderingen zijn in je leven. Maar hoe ga je er zelf mee om?
This card represents change, transitions, transformations, metamorphosis. But how do you accept it? What do you do? How do you use it?
Ja. Kijk, hoe ga je er zelf mee om? Ga er nog meer mee bezig met de gedachtekracht, zodat je één wordt met je spirituele eigen ik.
It all depends how you go about it. Go into thought and meditative state and get really busy so that you can see the change and that you can feel the change.
Klopt. En daarna kom je in balans. Focus je erop en dan kom je in balans. En je zal je weg gaan volgen hoe jij het wil en hoe je het na wil streven.
You will come into balance and then you will find your path. And then, you can see how you're going to develop this choice that you've made.
Ja, klopt. Ja, dat is deze kaart.
Lovely. Now we're going to the triple goddess. And Wendy's got the triple goddess tattoo in her neck. We saw that last week.
Arm?
And on her arm.
The triple moon.
I love that sign.
Yeah.
The high priestess.
Thank you. Love it too.
The high priestess wears it, the moon, the crown moon, but the high priestess in the tarot shows this.
Yeah.
Right. The triple goddess. In many modern pagan traditions, the triple goddess symbol is generally associated with the maiden, mother, and crone faces of a woman's life, as well as the faces of the moon waxing full and waning. The triple goddess symbolizes the cycles of not only womanhood, but of all life. The maiden represents enchantment, inception to the promise of new beginnings, and youthful enthusiasm signified by the waxing moon. The mother embodies fertility, sexuality, fulfillment, stability, power, and life represented by the full moon. The crone represents wisdom, repose, death, and endings, corresponding to the waning moon. The meaning of the card: life goes in cycles. Each aspect of the goddess is seen within us every day. We are not all three things at the same time, but they do come and go depending on the situation. Symbols as the triple goddess are gateways into a deeper reality by meditating on her different aspects. You will be able to see past the mundane into the divine and learn to know yourself more fully. The goddess stone or the gemstone is the rainbow moonstone. Rainbow moonstone is the high priestess of moonstone family, presiding over the cycles of life and spiritual initiation. It is a goddess stone par excellence, and it will guide you through the stages, stage of life, excuse me, with ease and joy. The incantation, maiden, mother, and the crone, each with wisdom of her own. Let me see the triple face and understand what each portrays.
Beautiful. I love this. Yeah.
I love the incantations. They're so wise and they're just ordinary sentences, but yet it sounds like the idea of a witch doing a spell, la la la, akrabadabra, and da 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 da, the rhyming thing, you know. I love it, but it's more beautiful.
Deze kaart duidt in principe aan van de triple moon. Als je deze getrokken hebt, van ga je even terug in het stukje verleden met je gedachten en sta stil in het hier en het nu.
The triple moon represents life and its phases. Sorry, I forgot.
Nee, van je, het is in principe zo van kijk terug in het verleden, want hè, de halve maan van de moon.
Look back, that's the one side of the moon. Then look at the now and look at the future.
Ja, de triple moon van de maan. Ga weer terug in het verleden, maar kijk ook echt hier en het hier en nu. En daarvanuit ga je verder naar de stukje toekomst. En als je
make sure that you look at now, so that you know where you can decide where to go in the future.
Ja, je hebt geleerd van het verleden en je gaat de toekomst, de nieuwe toekomst aan. En je leven zal anders zijn dan voorheen, omdat je daarvan geleerd hebt.
Your future will be better and will be different, new things, because you've learned from the past and the present.
Yeah. Yes. Okay.
The last card for this week, Wendy, and that's the unicorn, the mystical. That is, people say they don't exist, but they do in spiritual worlds. And it's mythology. The unicorn also comes from Greek and Roman mythology. Okay. The unicorn is a wondrous creature, a symbol of magic, miracles, purity, innocence, and enchantment. It is reputed to live for 1,000 years and to be the noblest of animals. The unicorn is proud, powerful, fiercely courageous, but also gentle, beneficent to his fellow creatures and the embodiment of perfect good. The unicorn's most important function has been a symbol of power and virility, as well as purity. It is a combination of opposites, the male horn and the female body, symbolizing the soul as the spark of the divine light in the darkness of matter and evil. The unicorn is feisty, fierce, and not easily hunted. But if a virgin were to sit in the forest, the unicorn would find her and lay its head upon her lap. The meaning of the card: the unicorn is a symbol of hope and positivity and possibility. Use the unicorn to recapture the free spirit within yourself and to avoid becoming jaded by the harsh realities of life. Tap into its power to create a feeling of freedom and to relieve stress. The crystal or the gemstone is rhodochrosite. Rhodochrosite is the stone of inner freedom, and it nourishes the inner child. It helps us break free from old patterns and gifts us the liberty to pursue the joy, love, and beauty in all things. Carry this stone to uplift your heart and open your eyes to the possibilities all around you. Incantation, joy, freedom, and possibility. This is what I ask of thee: to rid my life of discord and friction and replace them instead with calm benediction.
Beautiful cards. Love this more than the unicorn. It's magical.
I love the mystical.
The mystical.
And it reminds me a bit of Pegasus, the Greek mythology horse, because he's a unicorn, but he's got wings like an angel.
Yeah, it's very nice. Yeah, I love it. It's very nice. Nee, deze kaart duidt in principe aan van het is een kaart van hoop en mogelijkheden.
This is a card that emphasizes hope and possibilities.
En ook zo, ja, vermijd stress en situaties die eigenlijk niet goed voor je zijn.
Avoid stress and situations that aren't good for you. In other words, other people's drama as well.
Ja, voel je vrij en ga de toekomst aan en wees jezelf daarin.
Be free and be yourself and go into the future. Less stressed and be yourself.
Daar staat deze kaart voor.
Okay, well, like I said, we are going to discuss a little bit what is in this book. We're near the end, but next week we'll do a meditation. You're going to do a meditation in a minute. But I'm going to talk about incense. A lot of people might know what incense is. It also says in the book, use an incense when meditating. That's what the joss stick looks like. That is incense. But in the church, they have these like little kettles on chains, and they swing incense around to purify the air. And you get loads of sticks, and they're very cheap. And you get a little plank or little thing like that with mine's got stars on it, and also the Om sign. So they are decorative as well. And you've got a little hole, and you can put it in like that, and then you light it. So I'm going to light one of these joss sticks, and then I'm sorry you can't smell it, but I'm using patchouli, and patchouli is an oil that aromatherapists also use to purify.
Not blow it out. I do.
Otherwise it burns too quickly.
Okay. Ik doe het zo van, ik steek hem aan. Ja. En dan ga ik een beetje weer doen, dan gaat hij uit. Maar ik blaas hem eigenlijk nooit uit, want in de hekserij, zeg maar, als je dat uitblaast, dan brengt dat vaak ongeluk.
Oh, Wendy is saying, I'm sorry, I'm going to close the window. Somebody's mowing the lawn again, I think. Sorry about that noise. That's why I usually wear my headphones. So, Wendy say, when she lights, I'll just stick it out.
Yeah.
Dash it out. Come on. Wendy says, when she lights the joss stick, you mustn't blow it out, because in the witchdom, it can bring or mean good luck. So we're going to do it Wendy's way, by just lighting it, and then just sort of, it's like, how do you call it? Smudge. It's like smudging. Yeah. And just go around your area or your room and just smudge, and then it will burn.
Met de klok mee doe ik het dan, hè? Want dan ga je als ware. Ja, en dan, je open de cirkel.
Ja.
Ja.
Je open de cirkel, right. That's how we learn from each other. I never knew that, but I use joss sticks to create a sphere, and that's what the book says as well. It's in the book, so you can learn from it. And the meditation, you can take a card. So we'll take the magical horse. You can take any card from the deck, and if you haven't got the deck, then you might get a picture from YouTube or from an old from a magazine. So you can cut it out like a baby. If you want a baby, you can cut a picture out from the baby. If you would like to go on holiday, then get a picture from the destination that you would like to go to. And this is bothering me a bit, so I'm going to put it here. So you most probably will see it smoking. The smoke will drift that way, I suppose. So that's not me smoking. I am a smoker. But take a picture of something that you want to concentrate or focus on. Money if you want to, but you know, money doesn't buy happiness or love. So if you want, try to stay away from the material, but try to focus on something that will make you happy for long term. That's what I do with my meditation. When I do my meditation, I usually talk to my angels. Next week you will see my way of meditation, and that is partly Reiki and partly the angelic meditation and chakras, because the chakras from Reiki is different to the angelic chakras, because there's more of them. And so you can, if you want to concentrate on a chakra, you can get the color cards by Ina Segal or any other color cards, like the angel feather. Those are also color cards, and you can find them all back on my YouTube in the playlists introducing or reviewing decks. So you can choose, you can see the cards, you can choose which deck you would like to, or just use a picture from internet. So that is the idea behind it. So the author and the illustrator say use the card, and then you can sit down comfortably with a joss stick. And they advise in this book the lotus joss sticks, or the lotus scents, because the lotus is associated with mental clarity, increases focus and heightens the intelligence, which makes it ideal for meditation and finding answers. So you can also use the meaning of the cards, the crystal of the cards, and the incantation.
Yeah.
So that's the card. Just keep it in mind and then sit quietly, just like that. And you can, in some cases, you can put it to your third eye and just meditate. But you can hold the card or put the card in front of you. If you don't want to close your eyes, just put the card in front of you. And then just look at the card and see how serene the horse is and how peaceful it is, the different colors, and let go. So if you've got something to focus on, because some meditators or what you call it, instructors, say empty your mind. Well, nobody can empty your mind, because your mind goes 24 hours. That's why in the right way of meditation, you usually get a mantra. So when you do Reiki, you are also initiated into Reiki, Reiki 1, Reiki 2, Reiki 3, and a master can initiate you, and then they will give you an incantation, or rather a mantra. And you're not allowed to tell anybody your mantra, because that is just your mantra. So nowadays they have made it more possible and much easier for people to meditate and to focus on something with a card. And I think that's a very good solution and option for those that are not initiated into anything. So we're going to, when Wendy is ready, I will leave the joss stick burn, because you can light your own joss stick, and we'll wait for a minute. And then Wendy can explain what she's going to do, but we're going to do a form of meditation or healing. I'll let Wendy explain. Over to you, Wendy.
Okay, thank you. Hoe ik vaak in meditatie ga is het volgende. Ga op een rustige plek zitten, daar waar jij je prettig voelt. En dat kan in de natuur zijn, maar dat kan in je eigen huis zijn. Maar gewoon een momentje dat je tot jezelf kan komen.
The way she does meditation is she advises you to go sit alone in somewhere that is peaceful, that you will feel comfortable, that you won't get disturbed, whether it's in your house or whether it's in nature.
Wat ik vaak doe is, om even tot jezelf te komen. Wat doen wij mensen? We gaan naar het toilet. Daar kan je even tot jezelf komen. En dus dat doe ik dan vaak zelf ook. Of ik ga de natuur in. Of ik gewoon zit even een momentje op de bank. Het hoeft niet lang te duren.
Wendy says, well, you know, that's quite understandable. I get the drift. She didn't say that. But she said you can go to the toilet. That's where you can become yourself. Come into yourself. peaceful, or you can, especially in a house or an apartment with a family, then just go to the bathroom and just come to yourself or go outside into nature. But if you are alone at home and the children are at school or at work, if you've got grown-up children, then just sit in a chair and be peaceful. Come to yourself. Like, I've just closed the window because that noise will disturb me when I'm meditating.
Wat je ook doet, wat je ook kan doen, is bijvoorbeeld een muziekje erbij opzetten. Of je hebt het geluid van de vogeltjes om je heen buiten.
Sometimes you can also put a beautiful silent music on, meditation music. You will, I'll put down a few links, YouTube links. So that's really peaceful music. I'm busy making my own tape. By the way, you can listen to dolphin music, or if you like rushing water, you can get, you can on YouTube, you can also find waterfall music or birds. But if you're out in nature, you can enjoy the real life birds.
Als je dan dat doet, zeg maar, als ik aan de meditatie begin, ga ik altijd vragen om hulp. En dat doe ik op de volgende manier. Dan mag je eerst.
When I start my meditation, I first start by asking for help.
En ik doe dat op de volgende manier. Ik vraag dan alle goede lichtwezens.
I do this in this way. Every beautiful light creatures or creatures of the light.
En alle goede lichtwezens, goden, elfen en engelen.
Gods, goddesses, fairies and angels.
Dan zeg ik van, nou, sta mij bij, bescherm mij.
Stand by me and protect me.
En omring mij met wit licht.
And then I surround myself with white light.
Ook de hulp vragen dat hun dat voor jou doen.
Also ask them to put you in the white light.
Als ik dat heb gedaan, dan vraag ik van, dat ik even een momentje voor mezelf, of wat ik doe in de meditatie, ik vraag wel. Ik vraag om hulp eigenlijk, want waarom ga je anders tot jezelf, even tot je meditatie, even tot jezelf komen, je vraagt om hulp, dat je gewoon weer tot jezelf kan komen.
She says, why do you go meditate? Well, that's basically because you want to come to yourself, your inner me.
Ja,
en ook de. I ask them to give me, protect me and help me. And I just ask for what I need to bring me to myself.
Ja, dat ik gewoon mijn gedachten en mijn hart, dat het weer samenkomt.
So that my mind and heart and solar plex comes together.
Ja, dat je daarna kan manifesteren en dingen waar kan maken. En dat mag je vragen. Dat is alleen maar goed.
So that you can manifest, visualize afterwards the things that you want to manifest. And that's only good.
En op dat moment, dan als ik een vraag heb gesteld of dat ik gewoon even tot mezelf wil komen, dat zijn, kunnen meerdere vragen zijn. Maar ik zeg ook van gedachtekracht werk ik mee. Dus mijn gedachten zend ik uit.
When I ask a question or more questions, you can ask as many questions as you like, then I think that because the thought of power is strong and they will not.
En het wordt op een gegeven moment gehoord, dus dan kun je stil zijn in jezelf, genieten van de muziek om je heen of de vogeltjes die fluiten en laat het maar gaan, laat het maar gaan, laat het universum het maar meenemen. En dat is een, zeg maar, voor mij een meditatie, want wat ik geef komt dan weer terug en ik ga dan offeren als het ware.
When I meditate, then ask all the questions and thoughts, let your thoughts go out. They will pick up your energy, your questions. Give it to them, give it over to them. Don't try to control it. And then just take a moment and relax. Just think about things, just let it go. Just let it go. Let your thoughts go. And listen to the music or listen to the birds or whatever, however you have started your meditation. Just be yourself. Take a couple of minutes for yourself.
Het kan zijn. En dat
I'm giving out, so I will be back.
Ja, klopt. En soms is er niks en dan kun je even tot jezelf komen. Maar soms dan heb je wat en dan kun je dat meegeven. En je kan mediteren op verschillende manieren. En voor mij is dit een meditatie dat ik gewoon bij mezelf terug kan komen. En dat ik mag ontvangen en als ware geluk afdwingen. Zo zie ik dat.
This is for me a meditation. And sometimes there's nothing. Like you're not thinking, you're just actually relaxing. That also shows you that the meditation is working. And sometimes you just come back. And it's like when you drift, let your thoughts drift off. So you don't have to focus on that picture or whatever, because you'll just drift off. You can do it with your eyes closed or with your eyes open. It's just how you would like, just a minute, 10 minutes for yourself, just relaxing. And just let it happen. You're doing it for yourself, so you will feel rejuvenated again.
Wat ik dan doe op het moment als ik dan de meditatie heb gedaan, doe ik wel een offer. En een offer, dat kan zijn dat ik een bedanken is ook een offer. Iets meegeven in de natuur, een handje nootjes bijvoorbeeld.
Sorry? Handje nootjes?
Nootjes, bijvoorbeeld al een hand noten doe ik in, wel ongebrand en ongezouten. Die noten die strooi ik in de natuur en als bedank dat de vogeltjes die voor mij gezongen hebben het van mogen eten en dat helpt weer mee tot het betalen.
She says after that I give thanks and saying thank you and gratitude, that is already an offer. But sometimes I just take unsalted nuts or something for the birds, so and I throw that out into nature, so thanking the birds for that beautiful song.
Ja, of een apple of wat anders, maar gewoon wat, okay. Ja, als bedanken, weet je wel, van wat je kan, want dat doe je in de hekserij, dan ga je op een andere manier bedanken, zeg maar, dan gewoon als je thuis bent, dan oké, dan bedank je. Dan ga ik het weer na voor alle goede lichtwezens. Nou, dan het hele verhaaltje. Dan bedank ik en dan sluit ik het af. En dus met een wierookje ga ik dan weer sluiten. Dus je gaat dus met de klok mee beginnen. Dus dan wierook en dan sluit je het weer terug en dan is het klaar.
Ja. Well, she's the incantation she does at the beginning of the meditation of all light beings, fairies, angels and creatures. She thanks them and she shuts the meditation off because she's obviously our witch. And she takes the incense and when you start, you open it up with the clock the right way. And to close it off, you can go anti-clockwise and close off your meditation. And that is what the witches do. Okay. Yeah. And that's it. So that was awesome.
Yeah. Ik moet wel bijzeggen, ieder persoon doet het op zijn eigen manier. Ik doe het dan op deze manier omdat het goed voelt voor mij. En omdat ik weet wat het mij brengt en wat het manifesteert. Maar zo kan het voor een ander ook anders zijn. Maak wel je eigen weg daarin. Maak je eigen woorden. En doe het wat goed voelt voor jou.
She also says, this is my way of meditating. Everybody should adapt their meditation to their own style. What feels good for them. Because every form of meditation is okay, nothing is wrong. So it's just that where you feel comfortable with, just to show gratitude and thanks to the divine and the our beautiful creatures, our angels or our light beings or whatever. For some people, it might be a rock, something. There was a craze in the 1970s. That you had a piece of rock and you had a string on it. Your pet rock. I don't know whether you're old enough to remember that, but for other things mean different for everybody else. That is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah.
So thank you very much, Wendy. Now there is there are different sorts of incense, and I'll do a few, and there are more, like for matters of the heart, the incense is rose, musk, jasmine, gardenia, ginger, and cherry. Now there's also for courage, sweet pea, bergamot, frankincense, yarrow, and musk. For protection and dispel negativity, rose geranium, carnation, dragon's blood sage, juniper, copal, sandalwood, clove, galangal, benzoin, copal, and myrrh. For empowerment and strength, excuse me, you're going dark, so I think, let's have a look. Yes, are you still there? Yes, you're light again. I forgot to switch on the electricity. Things are happening here today. Okay, for empowerment and strength, dragon's blood, cinnamon, cypress, ginger, and pine. For luck, lemon, sandalwood, allspice, lotus, and strawberry. For wisdom, violet, apple, sage, jasmine, and cedarwood. For happiness, honeysuckle, hyacinth, apple blossom. For prosperity, patchouli, almond, bayberry, oak moss, bergamot, ginger. For healing, cleansing, and calming, vanilla, cinnamon, rosemary, thyme, clary, sage, clove, lavender, cedar, citronella, and patchouli. For purification, frankincense, copal, eucalyptus, cedarwood, orange blossom. For clarity, concentration, and focus, lemongrass, nag campa, peppermint, bergamot, cardamom, lotus, basil, clove, and cedarwood. For harmony and peace, chamomile, lilac, yalan, angelica, passion flower, and gardenia. And those are the joss sticks that you can use. Now, if you can't stand smoke, my suggestion is to get a burner. I'll show you what I mean. This is a burner. You most probably have seen them. You can put the candle in there. That's like a tea light.
Yeah.
That's like a tea light. That's got scents. I have scented tea lights. And you can put a little bit of water in there, and then you can use the oil, scented oils. These are concentrated oils, and that will give you two scents at the same time. So before, for example, you can use eucalyptus and you can use lavender, and that reverberates, rejuvenates, that's rejuvenating energy. And I sometimes prefer oil to joss sticks, especially when you're sitting here and it's drifting in your eyes.
We zeggen wel van, als de rook van de wierook naar je toe komt, dan heb je het hard nodig.
If Wendy says, if the smoke comes to you, then you need it really badly or urgently.
Yeah.
Okay. Would you like to add anything else to it, Wendy?
Nou goed, je had het over de stoom, zeg maar, van de olie. En daar werk ik zelf ook mee. Ik verkoop zelf ook die oliën. En je hebt verschillende soorten daarin, die dan samenkomt met eventueel een meditatie die je zou willen kunnen doen. Dus naar gevoel of hoe zit je in elkaar? Wat moet je doen? Wat wil je manifesteren? Wat wil je transformeren? Dat zijn allemaal dingen en dat kun je daarbij gebruiken. En, maar je kan zo op die manier. Het hoeft niet altijd
met wierook. Nee, klopt.
Wendy says, no, you don't have to do it with joss sticks all the time. It just what takes your fancy. And it all depends what you want to manifest as well. She sells them and there's little bottles. But you can get them at the health food store as well. At least in Holland you can.
Yeah.
But also on the market, the big black market. It's not a black market, but not anymore. The black market was when something fell off the back of the lorry, but it isn't like that anymore. But you can buy packets like 5 for €10 of joss sticks. You can buy oils. You can also get gemstones. So if you want to get the gemstones to carry with you, you can get them on the market or even on a paranormal fairs. Or spiritual fairs. So go and have a look if there is a fair around your in your place or in your surroundings or in your region or in your town. Go to one of these fairs and feel the gentle energy of the people that work on those fairs. They could be aromatherapists, they could be reflexologists, they could be the witches, they could be tarot readers, Lenormand readers, they could be, the, you know, Wendy's going to show that after the summer, that is a bowl that makes a sound. And they've got different types of bowls and every bowl has a tune. I've seen it done on my fair because I organized the fair in 2012. And there's also a Thai massage, Swedish massage, different massages. Go and have a look, go to the fairs. It's a nice day out. You can, you know, usually it's in some countries, it is entry is free or €3. And with the big fairs that are really commercialized, they are €10 to €15 to enter. So my advice is stay with the little people, stay with the small fairs. They're more homely, they feel more homely, the people are more homely, because on these big affairs everything is so commercial. And so I personally feel the snarriness, the jealousy, the competition. Yeah. Is on yeah. These big fairs. So go to the little fairs and also remember, guys and girls, please support your little businesses or your local businesses. Try to do it with the local businesses. Keep them. This is the message for today from everything. Also for yourself. Just imagine you want to start your business. You want people to come to you. Don't go to the big guys. Don't fill their pockets. Let's get back to the originality of the corner shop or the farm shop. And that's always healthier. You know where it comes from. Yeah. Okay, I think Wendy agrees because I see her nodding here. And that was this episode for this week. Thank you for being with us. Please give us the thumbs up. Go to our YouTube channels and give Wendy also the thumbs up. And please share the channel with family and friends. And I see you next week and with Wendy. Ciao, ciao.
Bye-bye.